Good morning, everybody. Excellency, my dear colleague, Heinz Fassmann, Director Generals, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you to Austria and hope you will also have time to spend a little bit of leisure time in our beautiful city, in our beautiful country, and especially you will come back and discuss with us on important topics like this topic, the topic of skills, of vocational education and training in Europe. It is key. It is key for our future that the next generations have the best education that we can give to them. And there, we have two ways to do this. This is the one path, the schools and the universities and everything we offer to them, which is of highly importance to Europe. And the second path we have is a path which is a combination. A combination which we are, for example, in Austria proud of, the apprenticeship, the dual system, the dual vocational system, where we have both training in school and training in companies. And I, myself, as a CEO, I've been 15 years CEO of different IT and telecom companies. Each time when I came to a company and I did not have an apprenticeship program, I introduced it. And if it was there, I tried to strengthen it because I saw how important this is for the companies to be competitive, to have the right skills in the companies, and also on the cultural situation, so on the culture of the company, it was key. It made a big difference if the company took this responsibility or it did not take this responsibility. So it's a common responsibility we share, companies, politicians, and institutions, that we make sure that this program is enlarged, that it is strengthened, and that it is brought to as many countries as possible. So therefore, I have chosen as one of the key topics in the council that I'm responsible for. I'm responsible for competition, combat on the one hand side, and on trade on the other hand side. I've decided to take this topic and together with you shape it and put a very strong focus on it. Because it is the way to the top that is apprenticeship and this VET is helping us to achieve. Let me give you a small insight in what is happening and what we're doing in Austria on that. So we have around 100,000 young people in this program. And we have started 6 months ago to put a special focus on what we are doing. As my ministry is called Digitalization and Economic Affairs, you might guess what we are doing is we want to put a digital content in every job which is learned by young people for the future. So each of them is necessary to have, even if it's a butcher, a baker, whatever it is. If you grow, if you build houses, you need building information modeling. If you produce other topics, you always need this digital part. So what we are doing is we're working on the 200 different jobs which are there and put the digital part in each of them. Second, we need to rethink what jobs we are offering. There need to be new jobs, like in September we will start with the e-commerce trader, so you can be a professional e-commerce trader, you can be a coder, so more software focused jobs. This is important also for the European economy, because if you ask companies what they need these digital skills very desperately, and they need a next generation that is helping them to improve their situations, have innovation and new ideas. So what we need to do is rework on the existing ones and add new jobs, and here the time frame, the time to market needs to reduce dramatically. It takes, especially in our country, maybe also in other, too long from the idea to the real job when the first young people are ready. So that is important to shorten this and to make it more efficient and much more focused. This is something very practical also that we need to achieve. The next topic is, if we look at the national qualification scheme, that is important to have a look where we put the different levels and where we put this special education track as a question of respect and a question of level where we put this achievement that the young people can have. So for us it was important to put the Meister, which is the highest grade on that in the national qualification scheme, on the same level as the Ingenieur from HTL in Austria, and also the Bachelor. So this is something we are working on, also working on different names for the different topics to make it more attractive. One important topic that we both share is how can we make this attractive to the parents to decide that the young people go and take this course and are deciding on this. So this is an important issue. We do not have, we're not allowed to forget the marketing side around it. For the future of Europe, I've mentioned it already, it's so crucial that I have put it on a very level, on a very top level, and I very much appreciate that experts from all the countries have chosen to come here and to discuss with us and get new insights. Why is this also for me very important? So if we look at Germany, Switzerland, Austria, and other countries who have implemented this, and other countries, especially the apprenticeship, who do not have it, we could think of the fact or a combination that it has something to do with also youth unemployment. So the more we work on the digital skills on the one hand side, and the more we work on the launch of apprenticeship across Europe on the other hand side, the lower the youth unemployment will be. So we will have here a good package that we can work on, something that we can really implement, and that is up to us to decide if we want to put more focus or less focus on it. On my side, you can be reassured that I will put really a lot of focus on this topic. I think it's one of the most important things. What we need is an in-depth evaluation to learn more from each other, which country is doing what inside the European Union. We need more transparency and comparability so that we can compare and share the best practices and exchange. And here we are very happy to offer this in this face of us heading the European Council. I think it's a unique opportunity for us in Austria and also internationally. If we look at the target group, let me also say a little bit about that one. It is important that we shape a lot of the programs a little bit differently. Today we have a long time learning, accompanying learning over, we're getting older and older, and it's not about 50 that we want to stop learning, and then sometimes we are thinking and rethinking our previous career and we want to do something different. Is the market ready for that? I don't think so. I think that it is important to have a look at two special target groups, and I would be happy if you could discuss this today also and share. This is one is women. If we look at Austria's situation, even if we are successful in this type of education, only one third of all people who start an apprenticeship are women. And 44%, almost 50%, are concentrated on very special three type of jobs, mainly in trade and in offices. So what we need is, we need to focus on this, and if we, and this is not a question of women rights or something, it's an economic question, because we need to put the women and attract women to go into technical jobs also technical studies, but especially to choose these jobs for having a better future and a better career and also a higher income. It is also for the companies which I have seen which put the focus on this that they are more successful, that they have more skilled people. And we have not really addressed the topic. We have addressed it but not yet found solutions. So I'm very happy if you can focus also on this and give us new ideas and new possibilities. What could we do on this area? And the second one I've already mentioned a little bit is what about people who are older than 20 years old. To give you an idea, in Austria only 5% that are older than 20 are starting an apprenticeship. In Germany it's a little bit more. After A-levels, around 20% to 25% go into this type of education. So we have a lot to do here because we need to address also younger generation, 20 to 30 and even older, that want to restart something new. And I think if we are only concentrating on young men between 16 and 20, we will not achieve and solve the skill shortage topic in Europe. So we need to address, like companies do, new markets, new customers, and these are women, these are elder generations, which are not in the focus and the target group at the moment. So I'm looking forward to your ideas. I'm looking forward to the results of this day. I want to thank you again that you have taken the time to come here, that you as experts want to share with us, and that both we in politics, you in institutions and very influential positions, we can make sure that Europe is most competitive, that the companies there have the best skilled people, and that we are creating new jobs this way and a good future for our next generation. Thank you very much.